Hello and welcome back to the workshop. The next build up is going to be Lindbergh's 1/64th scale Southern Belle stern wheel powered riverboat. Now I've done a full unboxing of this previously and now we're going to build it. So I'm not going to go through any of the parts in the kit. It does have 186 parts. I will link the video where you could see me take all the parts and look at them in the description. What I'm going to do now is open it up, start taking the parts out, start getting some glue on everything, and we'll be back right away with the subassembly show off. I'll see you soon. And just like that, we're already at the subassembly show off. Now what you see in front of you is about 2.5 hours of gluing, cutting parts free, removing ejection pin marks and flash. There's not a lot of ejection pin marks or flash that get in the way or are visible, but whatever it is, you'll want to cut it off. Now first thing we'll look at is the paddle wheel, and it looks beautiful. It assembles perfectly straight, no issues. You have to assemble the shaft. You have your two side wheels that are one piece each, and then you have 16 paddles all the way around. My suggestion is push the side pieces on, use one of the paddles to line them up perfectly with each other, glue that into place, and then let that dry completely for at least 30 minutes while you work on other stuff. Then come back and cut out all 16 paddles. Those are placed on numerous different trees, so if you think you don't have 16, just keep looking around your parts trees. You'll eventually find all 16 of them. Nice thin paddles with spacers on the back. That glues together, forms a perfectly straight assembly, and that's going to look lovely pushing the ship. It just goes right back there with mechanisms attached. Now we've got everything kind of loosely put together. That's why it looks a little wonky. There's no actual gaps when we get done. But of course, I wanted to show you how everything goes together. The lifeboat, or the boat that they use to get to shore, is on top. And I'll put that aside. That's one piece. I've assembled the wheelhouse. You can see that's a lovely assembly. Now there is no glass in anything because I'm going to be painting. Then I have to paint the window frames. Then from the inside, I can easily insert the glass pieces that come in the kit. The front window on this is a separate window frame with glass that goes in it. I will be posing it open a little bit so that I'm leaving out so I can paint everything separately. But that's your wheelhouse. Underneath the wheelhouse is one of the large cabins that we will slide off. You can see that that is kind of a fragile assembly, but it actually goes together nice and straight. There are locating marks on the inside. If you build it upside down like the directions say, you'll have no problems getting it all together. It does have a little bit of an arc to it. Once we place it on the deck around the smokestacks, lock it into place, glue it down, clamp it for 10 minutes, it's going to be perfectly straight. So that's your upper cabin with your doors and your windows. Again, this will all be painted separately. When I'm done, one of the last things I'll do before final assembly is slide those glass windows in. Then we have the upper deck, which is just one large piece that slides over the smokestacks gently. That's just one large piece, all one piece. We have our boilers and our smokestacks. Those are, of course, separate items on a plate that goes into the floor. None of those are attached, of course, because I want to paint, weather, and beat up the boilers a little bit. But you get two nice boilers, two nice smokestacks. Not a lot of seam work. Once you glue them tight, you can see the seam. But once you glue them tight with a good quality glue and paint them, you're not really going to notice. But there is nice rivet detail, and you're going to see those because they stick out in the front of the ship there. So you're going to see both of those. We'll take those off, and that's that large plate that they will mount to that you can paint up, mount the boilers to it, and then set it in place on the hull. I like how modular it is. Now this front wall that supports those upper decks, that's actually just snapped into place so I can paint that separately again. On the main deck is glued onto the hull. This is another cabin. This is the machine shed, I would call it. It's got two access doors. It's got windows. That, again, is another separate piece with two large slots for the paddle wheel arms to go through. That goes together nice and square. Now we've got the main hull sitting up here. We've got our mechanical room. This is what actually makes your paddle wheel go round and round. If you do decide to motorize the kit, none of the motorization, none of the motor battery pack or anything is in here, but you can set this up to work. If you build it so that you can still turn everything, you can set this up so that these will actually run off a belt on a little electric motor, and you can actually make this go across the water. I've actually left them unglued in there, just like they recommend. Maybe one day I'll put a very small 1.5 volt motor in there so I can make the paddle wheel go round and round very slowly while it sits on display. But that's your gear house. That just slips right into four little slots right in the back of the hull. And then those are going to attach to your paddle wheel back there with their arms to move the paddle wheel round and round. We got the main hull here all glued together as one piece. We've got our deck, our flat bottom, our rudder, and our paddle wheel arms there. That's all nice one piece. I can go ahead and paint that up and detail it as need be. And then we have the stand. It says Southern Belle, be easy to paint. The ship just sits on it loosely, obviously because it was normally battery powered. I'm going to end up gluing mine to it when we're all done so it doesn't go anywhere, because I'm not going to be putting it in the water to play with it like you could have back in the day. If I ever do motorize it, it'll still be sitting on a stand and just slowly turning. So that's all of our sub-assemblies. Again, my favorite part is that paddle wheel. Take your time. It'll go together just fine. Don't let it intimidate you. It's a skill level 3 kit. I don't see any reason why anyone who's put together more than 2 or 3 kits couldn't tackle this easily. Everything's going together real nice. So I'm going to start getting some paint on things. I only have some very small detail parts that attach to the hull later that I'm going to paint up separately on the trees, and then we'll put them on the hull when we start doing things. So I'm going to get the stand painted, the paddle wheel painted, the cabins, the decks, everything. I'll be working on those, and I'll come back during the process. Primer is on all the main parts that I did the sub-assemblies for, and what I did was give it a lot of mist coats of black primer to give me a little bit of shadows underneath everything. The parts that are going to be painted red, I've done in a red primer, such as the boat, the paddle wheel, the hull, all on there. Now, these aren't, of course, the final colors. What I'm going to do now is start painting over everything. I'm going to start putting a little bit of a glossier coat on the boilers, covering them up. The mechanic area, that's almost completely hidden. I'm probably just going to leave that the nice jet black that I painted it with primer. The paddle wheel's got to be painted red and green ringed. You can tell you I built it square because it rolls really nice. The decks are going to be a wood color. The upper decks will be a wood color. The walls will be a white color with red trim around all the windows. The hull here will be red, a darker red, and I'm going to apply a white stripe at the waterline all the way across there. I'll show you how I do that. Pretty simple, a lot easier than trying to paint it freehand. You'll enjoy seeing that. So I'm going to get all the detail on these, and then I can get the main hull glued together and situated, and then I start attaching all the little extra bits and bobs, get those painted, attached, and then we'll do a little bit of light weathering on this. So when I come back, most of this hull will be all painted and ready for assembly. Early on in painting, but it's starting to look, of course, a lot better than it did in primer. Now I've painted the hull the darker red color that I wanted to use. You can see the more orange red on the rowboat, and that's going to be stored upside down, so I'm not going to bother painting the inside whatsoever. I only paint mostly stuff you can see. Now we'll start taking it apart so you can see the different techniques I used. You remember what was black and what was red. Of course, the hull was red. The decks and the walls were all primered in black so I can get some shadows out of everything. What I like to do is I applied 4 different colors when I got going. The hull is a deep tomato red. The white walls are a light ivory. We've got a pavement for the boilers, the stacks, and the roof of the wheelhouse, and a khaki for the deck. That's it. 4 simple craft paint colors, all hand brushed on. Now, the paddle wheel is kind of hard to paint as one big unit. So after that was primed red, I did spray that with a similar color red from a spray can, just so I can have that drying over there and I could reach everything inside and out, get that all painted as one piece. So that'll be showing up later in the build. The wheelhouse, I wanted everything else to have a wood deck because that's how they had it on the box, and it's got that grain. But the roof of the wheelhouse, as you can see, it's got that rough white paint on it. The window trim still has to be done. The wheelhouse has this textured roof. What I wanted that to look like was tar paper, and it came out really nice, and it does look like tar paper. All I did was take 3 strips of painter's tape, has that nice rough texture to it, just like tar paper would. applied one strip here, and one strip down the middle, just like you would on a tar paper roof. All right, back then, they would have been using tar paper down south and stuff on the riverboats for the roofs, a lot of stuff like that. So then I just painted it with the pavement paint, lightly brushed over the blue, then I turned it upside down, cut my edges clean all around the sides, and there you have that really cool-looking tar paper roof on the very top of the pilot house. Since nobody's walking up there, it doesn't need to be a deck. I don't think they would have used any tar paper on here and here, because there are stairs that are going to come up. They would be walking around here. They'd have to be bringing down the rowboat to get to shore in certain areas and to secure different things on the barges they'd be pushing and whatnot. Then I went through and started painting white over the top of the black primer. Now, if you brush it lightly, back and forth, hand brush it lightly, same as the deck, you will start to get textures and tones of different colors because of the black base coat. And that looks like old painted whitewashed wood. I didn't want to go with a bright, bright, shiny new paint job. These guys work for a living. They're burning coal, you know, oil, whatever they're burning to make the boiler run for the steam operation at this time, whether it was oil or coal. So that's covering everything on the ship. It's not going to stay super clean for long. I wanted one that's been in service for a while. So that's how I started doing that. I started to brush light coats of the khaki, and you can see all the different, what I like to call, tonal variations in the wood start to come out real nice. Now, the mechanics room here, I didn't bother painting that at all because that's going to be completely hidden. There'll be two arms that come out of the back to operate the paddle wheel, but that's it. So there's no sense, unless I was going to light that inside there, to even bother dealing with it. So I'm not dealing with it at all. I painted the cabin that goes around it, painted the deck in the exact same way, painted the boilers up with the pavement color, left the smokestacks that faded charcoal-y black from the primer because they look real nice like that. I'll give them a little bit of a dry brush so it looks like they've had some coal coming out of them for a while. The deck that they are on, I used some dry brushing of a metalizer because they would have had those more than likely on a giant metal plate protecting the floor to keep those from setting the floor on fire, warping the deck, the extreme heat from those two boilers sitting right over it. So I've got those set up like that. Otherwise, it's pretty straightforward. What do I have to do now? I have to paint the window trim, the doors. I have to put the glass in. I have to do all the trim around the sides of the deck. I want to do in a light green color. And then I will be all set to go. So I'm going to just keep working on little bit by little bit as I do things, as I put smaller pieces on. We'll keep coming back for looks. Painting and weathering is all going great. I've got the red and green trim around the edges of the roof and the wheelhouse. We got everything clear coated with a matte clear, and then I weathered with a black wash to bring that all down and blend all the colors together. It's literally just black craft paint and some windshield washer. You can see the main deck has been darkened a little bit. We'll do a little more work to that. And I've metalized that plate with some dry brushing where they'd be walking back and forth by the boiler, shuffling their feet. Got the top deck weathered up. Got the rings that would be black iron where the smokestacks are coming through so the deck doesn't burn. We've got all that settled up. We've got the machine house all weathered up, ready to go. Got it all darkened out. It's just going to look absolutely awesome on there. Everything's coming together really nice. I told I'd show you how to do those white stripes on the hull. So we'll move the camera down here. As you can see, I've just got some green painter's tape. Use whatever type of masking tape works great for you. This works out well for me. All I do at this point is I take my white paint or whatever paint color I want the hull striped in, and I paint on numerous coats on here. Okay, I've got about 3 coats of paint that I let dry. It's craft paint, so if you get some on your cutting board, it's no big deal. But then all you do is you can eyeball this or you can measure it out. I just eyeball it because it's not hugely important to make sure that it's absolutely perfect. But we put that steel edge ruler on there, and you'll be able to see this in just a second. And then you just use a good blade right on your cutting mat. Don't do this on the kitchen table, unless you like living alone. Now you've got that stripe there, you can see where I cut. And all you have to do is pry the edge of the masking tape with your finger. And there we go. We're getting a nice white pinstripe. You can see the paint's moving with the tape. It bonds really well. It's not chipping off. I'm going to put that down there. I'll turn off the camera, then we'll apply that to the hull. And wherever you want it, front to back, and then just snip it off on the ends with your X-Acto knife. And you're all set to go. And that's how you can run a nice straight white line, a waterline mark on a hull, and not have to worry about masking or painting on the hull or screwing anything up. That's how I do them every single time, and they work really well. So I'm going to keep working on everything. I'm going to keep working on getting the deck together, getting all the main parts on. I got to put the glass in now that I'm done with those. And then I've got to paint up all the small details, get the bumpers on, get the barrels in, get the brass painted, get the little stove and the wheelhouse, get all that ready to go, start attaching everything. I'm going to get some twine out, and on the bumpers that are on the front for pushing barges, I'm going to wrap those in a little rope, drag some sandpaper on it, make a little beat up, and then wash it out. Then before I'm all done, I've got to do the base, of course. When I'm about ready for final assembly, we'll be back for one last update before we're all done. The closer you get to the end, the faster things start going. I've got the boilers mounted in. You can see the beautiful dry brushing on those. Really brings out that nice rivet and seam detail on the boilers with that metal treatment on the base plate that they're sitting on. I've got the cabin all done. I've got the window glued in. I just have to paint that frame the same red. I've got the glass mounted and everything. Nice shine on there. Got it in all the doors and windows, upper and lower. I've started doing some assembly. You can see I've got the paddle wheel on the back. I'm going to take that back off again. I just want to make sure it fit. I've got to paint the outside ring green, and then we'll get that mounted back on there. The paddle wheel, of course, isn't going to be very dirty at all compared to the rest of the ship because it's constantly getting circulated through a lot of frothy water. We've got the cabin all done. That slides over the top. It's got a little bit of a warp to it. All we're going to do is press it down and glue it in tight. We're not going to see that anymore. We're not going to have any problems with it. The cabin goes right up there. Pretty cool. I've got to put in the cabin, I've got to put a little stove, the wheel, the throttle. I've got to put some stuff on the roof here, a whistle, whatnot. I've got to put the rowboat on the back on its mounts. I've got to put the buckets in. I've got to put the railing around the second deck. I've got to put the stanchions. I've got to put the push bars on the front, the bumpers on the front, and decorate those. But it's all little stuff. You can see how cool that white line looks on the ship. I place that on there, and then I weather it with the rest of the hull. And there we go. We have that nice, straight, white line without a lot of work to do, and it has perfectly straight edges and is the right width front to back. And I didn't have to mask off half the ship and do a bunch of work. I also have to apply the Southern Bell decals here and try to fade them down a little bit with some dust, get them down so they're not as stark. So we've got a bunch of work to do. I'd say I got another 2 hours left in the boat, and then we'll be all done. When I come back, we'll have the final. Here we are at the final reveal of the Southern Bell, 1/64th scale by Lindbergh. Beautiful, beautiful model. If you take the time to paint it up, we didn't have any fit or issues. The decals work beautifully. You see all those are kind of faded? Once again, great thing to use to do a light fade on things is sanded tile grout. I used a pure white, dabbed it into the decal after it had set, and that's the nice faded look you get. We'll look at both sides. You can see you get that nice faded weathering, just like the rest of the ship's been worn. They haven't repainted it in a while. It's due. You get that real nice, very subtle fading. The decals set down beautifully. A little decal setting solution got them into all the grooves of the siding there and let it settle down. All the glass is in. I did add a couple extra things that are not in the kit. I added tarps and stowage. All right. I added this piece of stowage. It's 1/35th scale stowage. And in 1/64th scale, it looks like large tarps all rolled up around the ship. There's a big hole here for a switch when you motorize this. And I use that tarp to cover that up. I use sewing thread in different colors and textures to simulate deck ropes. I use sisal rope to simulate the huge tow ropes and strapping ropes that they bundle onto everything. Then I also took that same sisal rope, wrapped it around the bumpers there, and then took 80 grit sandpaper and raked it down really hard. Then I glued the whole piece onto the ship, so it looks like weather-worn and beat up. I did do two of the figures. I did the figure down here. I glued the ropes into his hands and had him running some ropes back and forth between the cleats, just doing some busy work, securing some ropes for some other stuff they have to do. Used some toothpicks to simulate maple poles up here and stained them. In the 1/64th scale, they'd be long enough for push poles and stuff like that, stuff that breaks often and they have to replace. Use the buckets and the barrels from the kit. Those are all included. Have them staged around the ship in different areas. Over on this side, they have hooks for the buckets, actually. You can see it dangling there. They throw in case they get a fire by the stove there, by the boilers. What else do we have on here? We've got more stowage up on the top of the cabin where they would be storing stuff. We got some more 1/35th scale stowage items from Tamiya, weathered, painted up so they look like regular tarps. These tarps here that are a more natural flavored, natural colored tarp over the top of the ship are actual toilet paper, single ply, folded up and soaked with diluted white glue. Then I folded them to look like a tarp. Then I weathered them and washed them a little bit after they had dried to shape on the top of the lifeboat there, or the rowboat, whatever they use it for. And then I also took some toothpicks, smashed them down, flattened them out, and shoved them underneath the boat to use as the oars. So that was just really cheap stuff anyone has sitting around their shop that they can use to add a little more detail to a cool ship like this. Did a lot of weathering off the cleats, dropping that grease and oil and water running off the deck on either one to be a more common area from dragging ropes up and down. Like I said, we smoothed out the decals there into the grooves and faded them so they look like the boat. The paddle wheel has minor weathering done to it. We don't want to get too deep into that because it's always wet, so it's going to have more of a glossy, cleaner look than the mechanics, which I greased up a lot deeper and all that. They always had to keep those oils. The railing went on fine. I didn't have any problems with this kit at all. I did minor weathering on the stacks and smoked out the top of them. The cabin, all of the upper cabin completely removes if I wanted to mechanize that drivetrain. This will actually turn, so I left it loose. Maybe when I'm an older man, I will do it. You can see inside the cabin there where I did the tar paper roof. Got all the glass in, opened the window in the front for some fresh air. We've got the pilot, his little stove, the wheel, and the throttle there. This goes on and off. It's a little bit of a rough fit, but it's something you'll get it on, it'll fit perfectly. So, it looks wonderful. I love it. It's going to be in the display. There will be a slideshow right after this with some better pictures so you can see more detail. Once again, I thank you for watching the workshop, and we will see you at the next review.